An outbreak of Ebola in West Africa is now being called an unprecedented epidemic. Cases have been identified in Guinea's capital city and now beyond its borders, too. At least 80 people have died. Ebola is considered one of the world's most deadly diseases. And as Stuart Greer reports, aid organizations are working hard to contain it.
Preparing to do battle with one of the deadliest viruses on the planet. Medical teams in the West African nation of Guinea cover themselves head to toe in protective gear in the desperate battle to contain the fatal outbreak. There have been isolated cases of Ebola in Africa before, but never anything on this scale. This is an unprecedented epidemic, says Michel Van Erp from Doctors Without Borders. We're facing the most aggressive strain that kills 9 out of 10 patients. Discovered in Zaire in 1976, the Ebola virus can cause gruesome internal and external hemorrhaging. The victims slowly bleed to death. There is no vaccine, no cure. All doctors can do is keep a patient comfortable and isolated so others aren't infected.
There's really very little that modern medicine can do for this. Your white blood cells start attacking you instead of attacking the virus. And this is essentially what causes your organs to fail.
The outbreak began in January in a remote southeast region of Guinea called Nzérékoré. It's now spread to neighboring Liberia, with suspected cases in Sierra Leone. But most worrisome is the number of new infections in Guinea's coastal capital, Conakry. Fear has gripped the densely packed city of 2 million. Unsure what to do, people are buying bleach to disinfect their homes.
I'm panicked. I'm very confused.
And large public gatherings, like concerts and sporting events, have been canceled.
And setting one of these very, at least mildly contagious viruses loose in that kind of population center really has the risk of a humanitarian disaster.
With an international airport and Atlantic Harbor in the capital, health officials are screening travelers in the scramble to keep the deadly virus from spreading even further beyond Guinea's borders. Stuart Greer, Global News, London.